Hey guys, Synyster Gates here from Avenged Sevenfold, and I wanted to give you an introduction to my new amp and show you all the different possibilities, different tones, all the different applications and uses, and some bells and whistles and some stuff that you might not find on your everyday stack. So for the first channel, we're going to start with the one that I'm probably going to use primarily for live settings and definitely for leads and, you know, big saturated tones, and that's going to be the lead two. Sounds pretty good straight out of the box. It's what it's designed to do, so pretty much everything's pointing high noon. It's really nice and tight, and just a lot of personality. So the second channel we're gonna do is lead one. And this is going to be more of a rock-based, kind of whinier, nice and saturated and cool for rock stuff. It's got a lot of balls too, and there's a slight variance in tone and EQ kind of setting. So a lot of guys probably would like to use this for their rhythm channel. It gets great breakup and it just sounds really, really cool. So, I mean, just to experiment with it and check it out. So for our third channel, we have the clean channel. There's two clean voicings on this, one American-based and the second UK-based. First, we're gonna start with the American, and just a slightly darker, kind of more rich, kind of warm sound. You might find this in, I mean, you just find your own different applications, but I like to play a little jazz on it, some richer voicings sometimes, but. That's pretty cool. And you have the UK voicing, and this is really cool for a lot of the stuff that we're doing, you know, for Avenged and that really nice crystal clear kind of arpeggiated sound. You know, you get like it's good for metal, good for rock, good for everybody. So now we come to the gate. It's all the way down right now. This guy's awesome. Basically, so it's not feeding back even too much right now, so we'll crank it a little bit. It's starting to get a little bit noisy here. I mean, this thing's fucking blasting. Crank it maybe halfway and you're pretty much good, and you still have a little, you can still kind of hear the guitar. It doesn't cut out all the way, it's not squeezing it too much, the playability is great. And then, I mean, even if you go a little crazier, crank up the gain and push it. I mean, you can go to about 3/4. And you're still good. Also, we have, for whatever kind of guitar you want to play and send through here, we have a focus knob which adjusts bottom ends and, you know, EQs, and so you can kind of tighten it up or get a nice full, like sluggish, kind of sludgy bottom end for new metal type stuff. I mean, just you can run anything through it. I mean, 7-string guitars, 8-string guitars, and you can tighten it up or loosen it up depending on your preference. So it's a pretty cool feature, I think. Basically, when you pull it out of the box, it's pretty much rip-roaring, ready to go. But it's very customizable. It's always going to have, you know, a very classic sound and element to it. But I mean, these aren't just there for show. I mean, the mids crank. You can get a really nice, you can drop the mids and get a great scoop, uber metal kind of feel to it. So I mean, it definitely runs the gamut of doing it without it ever encroaching upon kind of a novelty sort of sound or sense at all, which I think is really cool and was pretty tough to ascertain. But we worked through it and got it. So whatever your style, man, it sounds great and always retains that really classic feel to it.